Hello class. So today in this experiment we are going to do the detection of E. coli DNA using the polymerase chain reaction. So here in the methodology, so we have already extracted isolated the E. coli DNA, and the DNA is over here. I can post the technique and the procedure for how to extract the DNA, and then we will proceed with So today we are going to proceed with the PCR, and these are all the reagents that we need for PCR. So we have the primers over here, the P1 and the P2, which are just the forward and the reverse primers for detecting the E. coli DNA. We have the GOTAC green mixture, which is a mixture of all the DNTPs and the MgCl2s and other things that we need in our reaction. We have water over here that we need as well. And besides all this, we have the positive control and the E. coli DNA, which we will be using in our reaction. So to prepare our master mix, we have, as I explained, we have the forward and the reverse primer, the GOTAC and the water. So these are the reagents we need to make the master mix, and these are the amounts we need in microliters. We need 1.5 of each primer, then we need 10 microliters of GOTAC and 7 microliters of water. We have altogether 5 samples over here. One is the positive control, one is negative control, and we have three samples of our DNA. It will be the same DNA, but we are just doing triplicates of that. Since we have 5 samples here, so we are just taking, like, we need to do a multiplication and get prepare a master mix for all the 5 samples together. So this is the value we have obtained when we multiplied with 5.5. We just took an extra, we kept an extra amount of all the reagents. Out of all the reagents, we will be extracting 20 microliters after preparing the master mix into each of these tubes. And then we will be adding 5 microliters of the E. coli DNA into this 3 samples tube. And we will be adding the positive control in the positive control tube, and the negative control will only have 5 microliters of water. So we have to prepare our master mix now. For that, we have all our reagents over here. Now we have to take the desired volume of each. We have to add the GOTAC master mix first. That is the green reagent, which has the MgCl2s, the DNTPs, and all the required reagents, which will be needed in the PCR. So 55 microliters of GOTAC will be needed here. We have the green mix over here. We have to transfer 55 microliters of GOTAC into a new tube, which will have our master mix solution. Then we need 38.5 microliters of water. And now we have to add both the primers at the end. So for each primer, we need 8.25 microliters. So this is P1, which is the forward primer. And lastly, we need the P2, which is the reverse primer. So this is the final master mix that we have prepared. We will vortex this and spin it for a few seconds before we put it in individual PCR tubes. We have added the master mix, the 20 microliters of master mix, into each of the 5 tubes. So we have tubes labeled as S3, which is sample 3, sample 2, and S. And then we have the positive control and negative control. So these are just the triplicates of the same sample, and this is a separate sample, and this will be just water instead of the DNA. Now we have to add the E. coli DNA to the respective S tubes. So we have the E. coli DNA here. We'll only be adding 5 microliters of the E. coli DNA. So this is tube 1. In all the tubes, we have added the E. coli DNA. Now we'll have to add the 5 microliters of positive control and water to the plus and minus tubes. So this is the DNA, double-stranded DNA positive control. We're going to add 5 microliters of this. And then at the end, so this is, when we run the gel, this should not give any band because it's just water. So we add 5 microliters of this in the last tube, which is the negative control tube. Okay class, so we have prepared all the solutions here. We have vortexed and spun it. So all the 5 solutions are here. Now this is a thermocycler which we'll be using to amplify the E. coli DNA. Before we use this machine, so we have to put the samples over here. So this is how you put your samples. Now you can close the lid. And this is the parameter which we need. So you have the parameters in your protocol as well. So I'll explain you what each one means. So the PCR will amplify the given portion of your DNA. So you have both the primers which will anneal to specific regions of the DNA and it will amplify those regions. But for the PCR to work, it should have like 2 strands of DNA. So it can only work for DNAs and not for RNAs or other things. You have the initial parameter set as 94 degrees for 5 minutes. So this is just the denaturation step which we need. So the DNA strands are always annealed together. So for the strands to separate out, we need this step, which is the denaturation step. We need this for a few minutes. Next, we have the elongation step, where the primers, your forward and the reverse primers will anneal to the specific regions of your double-stranded DNA. So this will continue for like 30 seconds. Then you have like extension step, which is a little bit higher than the elongation step. So in the extension step, the annealed primer will start synthesizing, not the primers, but the DNA polymerase or the tag polymerase will start synthesizing the DNA, taking primer as starting point. So this will continue for another few minutes, and then there's a total of 35 cycles, and after everything is completed, it will reach a 4 degree centigrade. So now I'm going to start the machine. So this machine takes some time to initialize and start. So now the machine is running, and the remaining time over here is 1 hour 13 minutes and 2 seconds. So first the lid will be heated and then the machine will start. So we'll have to wait for a few hours, like 1 hour 13 minutes, for the reaction to complete, and then once it's done, we can come and take the samples out from here.